It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. To the 34. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead them to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week, and right now we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. Now it's Gurley. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, "Are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down." They love being physical.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. On the counter, Gurley. And if there was a lane there, it closed up quickly as he stopped for no gain. Second down. The defensive line made pretty easy work of the offensive line that time.
And people get tired of the cliche that the battle is won in the trenches. But it's a cliche because it's true. And how about the battle right there? One on the edge. And the ball carrier did not benefit.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Here's Gurley. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. He lost two there, and it's third down. A throw he'd like to have back. Now fourth down. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
Rosen and the Dolphins now with a first and 10 at their own 18. Now the first carry for Bush. He's got a first down and more past the 30. And finally taken down at the 36-yard line. 18 big yards on that one and a Miami first. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Well, Rosen is stripped of the football, and the Jags grab it. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line.
Well, partner, they went empty set there. No backs in the backfield. All receivers out in the pattern. And in this situation, you know what the quarterback has to do? Act as his own blitz control.
Yeah, he's got nobody else there to protect.
Which means he's got to get rid of the football and absorb the hit, but not go down and fumble the ball.
Tackle that time by Jerome Baker out of Ohio State.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Now Gurley. Gurley's got the first down and then some. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. A great effort there. His ninth touchdown of the season as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Extra point tacked on by Lambeau. And that makes the score 7-0. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over. The other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
They'll break the huddle, send three receivers left, one to the right on second and five. Now it's Rosen. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. They'll look to throw on first down with Josh Rosen. And he hits his target. It's Kenny Stills. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Kenny Stills, his second touchdown on the season as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Go, go, go. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got to the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there. Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play. But if you're on offense, be aware, a ball may come your way.
Now on second down, this is Gurley. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And now it's first and 10, a big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Following the penalty, it's Gurley. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. He lost six there on the first down play.
So if you've been playing defense in this one, there's a little bit of the good and some bad, because they did give up the touchdown run to him earlier, but shut him down otherwise.
Outside of that, you're exactly right. I would say they've contained him very well.
One.
Now on second and 16, Foles. And that is intercepted on the sideline. Wait, no. They'll say no. It was caught out of bounds. So this is just an incompletion here. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Mike 50.
Under.
Hey, Katie. Check
25.
Slip.
Yes.
Wide. Get wide.
Go with 5-3. Let's go. Great.
Check.
Here's Gurley now, out of the gun. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. It's a 6-yard loss on the play. And that's going to bring up a fourth down. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown. Now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8 at the 18-yard line.
Now, this will probably be the last play of the quarter. These two teams all tied after one. Second quarter from Miami. It's the Dolphins with the football as they've got a 2nd and 8 forthcoming. It's complete. Stills. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. The last completion actually lost a yard, so now they'll need to convert on third down. A give. This is Bush. And he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. It's a gain of just 3, and the offense likely going to yield to the punting unit here on fourth down. On fourth down, Matt Hawk is on to punt. Here comes Grant on the return. That's a 49-yard punt, 8, though, on the return. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10.
Let's
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. They go play action here on first down. Rolling to his right. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. The lines move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles. So just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
The second down play, not much better than the first. Just a gain of one there.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Foles. Eluding the pressure right. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Minka Fitzpatrick, and they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line.
I think that interception happened for two reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit, and receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. So there's a guy lurking, took the ball from
him. Yeah, so don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open?
Got to know that you're open. Otherwise, just don't do it.
Rosen and the Dolphins now with a first and 10 at their own 46. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. He's able to rip off 32 on that one. It's a first down.
Well, partner, I have to say they caught him in the right defense there. Nickel set, fifth defensive back on the field, and they love to run against that because now you typically get a bigger blocker on a smaller defender.
Yeah, because those DBs like you, they want the interception. They're not as worried about the running play, right?
Not at all. I still remember being in school.
And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Jakeem Grant, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Dolphins have taken the lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And that makes the score 14-7. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is taken at his 4. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up two straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they get this game tied up.
A big change in field position there. That's 40 yards on the catch and run. Now Foles. He's going to have the hook up to Ross.
Touchdown, baby. You got the key to this one.
Give him 32 on the play. Now that's two big catches that he's had on this drive alone.
And I can hear it right now. If they give up a third to him, whoever does that, go stand on the other sideline. You're persona non grata on our team at that point.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. On first and goal, Gurley. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A great play there with his second touchdown here in this first half. As they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. Point after by Lambeau, up and good. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And we've got a tie game here, a back-and-forth first half. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
Brings up second and eight at the 27-yard line.
The last run got a couple. Here, second and eight.
Hey, watch the screen. Watch the screen.
Monday.
Watch the screen.
Check four.
On the run, it's Bush. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom. Quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
On third down, Rosen. And he finds Stills, complete. A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion. So the defense blitzed. A nice job picking that up, completing the pass.
And how in sync was the quarterback in his center on that play? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged, because now they know there are going to be extra guys coming at the quarterback, so they got their assignments down pat and kept them away from it. And he's able to step up in the pocket and fire one now for a really good strike.
Brings up second and three at the Jaguars.
Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game.
I know he felt that one.
Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. On second down now, it's Bush. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down. So third and two, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts, as they'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. No move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and five.
You better alert. Right now, you better.
They're going on fourth down. Rosen and Stills bringing it in. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. The Dolphins can't convert on fourth down. And the Jaguars are going to take possession here on the turnover on downs. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Gurley again here on first down. And he's across midfield and into Miami territory. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down. They run. It's Gurley. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half.
Hey, it's over.
Just like that.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. That one complete to D.D. Westbrook. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 36. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Gurley. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9. Yet another carry here tonight for Gurley. They follow up the first down one-yard run with a minimal gain of 2.
Get him, boys!
Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down. He'll look to throw. And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. Jerome Baker able to record his 5th sack of the season. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout called. This is Josh Lambeau. He hit from 57 a year ago. They spot it on the midfield stripe, so it is a 60-yard attempt here. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. So we've reached halftime here with the visiting Jaguars out on top. As we go up to Orlando now and hand it over to Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This will be fielded at the 6. And it'll be taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. From the 21, it's 2nd and 10. It's caught. Stills right side. And they're able to get this one across the 35. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
They can't hang with us.
Hey, Steve Six.
Now Rosen on first down. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Josh Allen just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front, nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
4 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have to contend with a 3rd and 13.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
Focus. Hey! Let's go. On that. Here I come.
Kill, kill, kill.
My neck.
Tighten up.
80.
Alert three.
Third and long here for Rosen. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 36. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's. And that's exactly what they did there.
On first down, nothing opening up really on the running play. Give him maybe a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Hey, alert.
They'll keep it in the hands of Bush. And he's got some space here. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
The more football I watch, the more I want to check and see if teams are going to panic when they're down on the scoreboard. And this team has shown no signs of doing that. A lot of the time, they come out after the half. Things haven't worked so well in the first go-around. They want to throw the football like crazy. But the way to open up throwing the ball is to run it. And they've run it well here to start the second half.
From the red zone now, here's Rosen on first down. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. That throw good for four. It's second down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Four yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. They'll hand it off to Bush, and he'll fight his way down right around the 12. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down and four now. If you're going to run against this unit, especially down here, just beware. I mean, they're the top rushing defense in the league.
Yeah, and then they go ahead and they double down with the whole thing because you think, okay, let's throw the ball. Oh, yeah, that's right. They defend the pass pretty well, too. Very difficult task right now.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That's a good job there creating the contact to force the incompletion. And now, since it's fourth down, that should set up a field goal situation.
And a nice sigh of relief defensively to be able to hold them to three. Sanders' kick is good. And that will tie things at 17-all. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, Parker, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting three? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find ones that get you into the end zone and get you six?
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game. We'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You got everything going your way. You've probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Again, they run with Gurley. He's got a first down and then some at midfield. He's at the 30. 10. Touchdown, Jaguars. A big play there. His third touchdown of the game, number 11 on the year, as his guys are able to regain the lead. A extra point tacked on by Lambeau. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them, not easily done.
Now this may be a free play here for Rosen. And he's going to go down, but a penalty marker too, and they might very well have jumped the snap there. So they will accept the penalty and move forward.
They can't stop me out here.
Gets to him again. Well, there was second long. Now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Let's go, defenses. Get up.
From the gun on third down, it's Rosen. And it's caught by Parker. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 18 big yards on that one, and a Miami first. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Back now in Miami. It's Dolphin football, but they trail here as we get set for the fourth. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A Miami first down, that one going for a gain of 11. And that last reception puts him over 150 yards now on the game, Charles.
And now it's not just execution, it's not just performance, it's a mental aspect that's going on. Because right now, he has kept the defense so much on their heels, got them looking at each other. Who's going to cover this guy, and what type of coverage can we put out there to try and slow him down?
Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
This is one of those plays that has an equal chance of either being a big gain or a big loss, but with the college influence, we're seeing more of these plays come into the NFL.
What's the ball? Shady. Mike 51,
hey, let's get this. On first down, it's Rosen. Flushed out right. And here he's got Grant. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
First and 10 at the 15-yard line.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Devontae Parker was the intended receiver, but it's going to be second down. They don't get the hookup there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's a perfect word for it, precise, because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, let's face it, it's not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
Brings up third and 5.
The Dolphins on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be third and 5.
Hey, Alpha!
Pilot, 64, weak.
And watch the slam. Check, 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 check.
Hey. Again, it's Rosen. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he's got the first, but we also have a flag on the field. And they're already walking backwards. And this third down looking very tough after the holding penalty. Third and long.
Check, 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 check. Check, check, check.
Throwing again, it's Rosen. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
They went with the dive look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
Sanders' kick is good, and that'll bring him back within four. So an interesting call there to take the three. I mean, I guess they're thinking that their hands were tied, but, you know, fourth quarter, that field goal might not help them that much in the air.
Yeah, eventually they're going to need the touchdown. The thinking must have been they didn't feel confident about picking it up there, hoping maybe on defense they can get better field position, get a turnover, get a better play, and then they'll have a chance to attack the end zone.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game. And you hear a lot about two-minute offense and four-minute offense. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the four-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11.
Hey, check my 50. Mike is a 50.
Check. Here's Foles. That one complete. He finds Shark. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
Here we go, here we go, here we go. 20!
50 to Mike, 50 to Mike. Night, night, sweetheart.
Here comes a 20th carry for Gurley. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. A quick throw now complete to Ross. Touchdown, Jaguars! John Ross. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Jaguars are able to widen their lead. Point after by Lambeau, up and good. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score.
Hey, Echo.
They'll look to throw on first down with Josh Rosen. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Moss. A Miami first down on the 14-yard pickup.
44 to Mike. 44.
Throwing now, Rosen on first down. On the move to his left. Throw left side complete. That's Grant. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. That's good for 28 yards. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Rosen on first and 10. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
At the Jaguars' 14-yard line.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down.
Hey, Foxtrot!
Rosen to throw again. And he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now.
Brings up third and 5.
They come up now, third and 5, following the incomplete pass.
Hey, alert 3, alert 3.
Watch the ship, watch the ship.
Right here, guys. Fight 51. Mike.
They'll run it with Bush. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. It's complete to Graham. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down.
First and goal at the 8-yard
line.
From the shotgun, it's Rosen. Buying time to his receiver. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Jadeveon Clowney in there to drop him as that clock continues to run.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And that is caught, but the back judge right there to say incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Mike Gesicki, but now it's third and goal. You got to think this is likely four down territory anyway, but they'll try to punch it in now on third and goal.
You think you're going to get this?
36.
From the gun, it's Rosen. And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way down, field. They got the touchdown, but it's almost like,
doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
And he'll get into the end zone as the 2-point conversion is successful. So just a 3-point game now as they send this one away. This is taken at the 3.
Let's go!
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And 3 timeouts remaining here defensively, but really not much reason to use them at this point as this one is all but over.
If they use the timeouts here, it's strictly for show. We got plenty to catch.
Give them 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Put them on the buses. Let's put that team on the bus. Whip. Watch the whip.
Another carry now for Gurley. He's got a first down past the 30.
Safety's creeping.
And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. So this will be a win for Jacksonville. And I tell you, this was a fun one. Just a close game. Nothing comes easy in this league, as you know. They had to work for that victory.
I've got to go back to what you just said. Nothing comes easy in this league. How many times have we talked to coaches prior to a game and assessed, you know, the strengths, the weaknesses, the whole deal? Even in games when one coach was a decided favorite, what do they always say to us? But you do know this is really a 7-point league. 7 points either way usually decides a ball game. We had exactly that in this one.
And not only that, but this is a gutsy road victory, one they can hang their hat on. So for Jacksonville, that early momentum continues here as they move to 4-0, and they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for the Dolphins, the defeat is their first of the year as they drop to 3-1, and they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
big numbers. Big numbers. 100-minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers. Big numbers. Whole team got it, that's a big number.
Hey, foreign cars, foreign seats with the foreign leather. Foreign number, put the card in the ATM in the sad era. Yeah, flex mode, this ain't Southwest, this is jet. I ain't gotta shut the cell off, it's a iPhone, I got a jet mode. Bad be presto. If you wanna come, let's go. We ain't going nowhere special. I just wanna see Modesto. Hit your thought, I'ma catch those. Mexican, dummy peso. Bitch, you suck, I'll replace those. Number save, no name, though. We need more, tell them we need more. Put numbers on the board, let them keep a score. Hey, 16 cars in my front yard.
Yeah, wrist man, check the wrist man, got him hot. Ay, man can't ball like this man, Lord. Pass the big scam, when he stretch a distance. I'm talking a few 100,000 yards, you just on your fifth grand. Run it up, 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 count it up. Hey, hundreds and fifties and twenties, no fives and no singles, don't count on them. Hey, she wanted like me, cause I claim she can't count on him. She tried to be nosy and hit up my ex, she like, girl, you can count on him.
Hey, hey, we need more, tell him we need more. Putting numbers on the board, let them keep a score. Hey, 16 cars in my front yard. Hey, 30 on my wrist, bullet points a car.
Big numbers, big numbers. 100-minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers. Whole team count it, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers. 100-minute bag, that's a big number.
Yeah, I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another cell. He still buy me why I sell. I could get it by myself. These, I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself, yeah. Feel like Ginger from Casino. Aces up my sleeve, though. Right before I leave, I said like I'm Dino. Think I'm part Italian, but then I'm Gino. Snowflake the medallion, the skin on cappuccino. I don't kiss and tell, keep your distance from myself. Had a genie with the snails in a five-star hotel. And I wish you well when they wish for me to fail. I might donate petty bills, they can't get it by theyself.
That's why you treat my friend good, but not too good. I give them too much, then they don't need me.
Yeah, I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another cell. He still buy me why I sell. I could get it by myself. These I could get it by myself. I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself. Yeah. I'ma get it either way. I don't even gotta say.
Guys, we all watched the film from yesterday, and I hope everyone knows it was.
Nice. Whitey!